All right, welcome back everybody to Altcoin Daily. My name is Aaron. Let's jump right in. So at the time of recording, Bitcoin is sitting just below 5,700. And just yesterday, Bitcoin popped up to 5,800. And for the past 3, 4, or 5 days, Bitcoin has been seeing substantial growth. For the past 2 weeks, Bitcoin has been seeing substantial growth. I mean, you could say for the past 4 months, Bitcoin has been seeing substantial growth. Now, despite this newfound sense of hope that we have in the market, I'm not buying Bitcoin right now, and I'm going to tell you why. Before I get into it, let me just preface this by saying I'm not a financial expert. Plenty of people are going to make better investment decisions than I am. I'm just a normal guy, just like you. I'm a cryptocurrency investor, a cryptocurrency enthusiast. So if you want to buy Bitcoin, go ahead and buy Bitcoin. If you don't want to buy Bitcoin, don't buy Bitcoin. I'm just telling you what I'm doing. So check this out. I don't know if you remember, but when Bitcoin was trading below 4,000, but above 3,000 all this time over here, I was making a lot of videos at this time, and I was saying, I think Bitcoin could go lower. A lot of people agreed with this sentiment, but within those same videos where I was saying, I think Bitcoin might go lower, I was telling you in each one of those videos, I'm cost averaging right now. And you can go in the videos, you can go in the comments, and people would comment, you're foolish. You're foolish for cost averaging. Bitcoin's going to go lower. Why would you buy around 3,500 when you could buy when it goes lower? Yet I would still cost average. Well, now that Bitcoin is 5,600, many people are FOMOing in. Many people are, they don't want to miss the boat for Bitcoin to go on the next bull run. But that's not really what I'm thinking. First of all, there's tons of resistance at about 6,100, 6,200, tons of resistance. So here's the thing. I think Bitcoin is going to have a hard time breaking above this. But let's just say it easily breaks above $6,000. Then if we've been heading up for what, the past 3 months straight? I mean, we've been seeing substantial growth for the past month straight. And if we break above 6,000, say we go to 7,000, I still bet that we would come back down and then test this support at 6,100. So if I have to wait and see Bitcoin rally up to 7,000, 8,000, then retest around 6,000, I'm okay with paying a little bit of a higher price if Bitcoin then never falls below 6,000 again, but I would still buy Bitcoin just above 6,000. If that would even be a possible scenario. Now, that's not what I think is going to happen. Because we have such strong resistance around 6,200, what I think is going to happen is, now we could stay above 5,000 for another couple of weeks, but I think eventually we will have to trend downward and test some of this newfound support. And if you go back and you look at what happened in the 2014-2015 bear market, you're going to see, check this out. You're going to see that after Bitcoin bottomed, again, we went on a rally. We rallied up for 2 months. So Bitcoin went from $170 all the way up to almost $300. And then we trended back down. Now, we never ended up going lower than the bottom. But you can see here that traded sideways for a long time. So just because we're going up now, just because we've been going up for the past couple months, doesn't mean that we won't trend downwards, and I'm not saying we'd even go below 3,100. What I'm saying is that we have been trending upwards for a long time. We have major resistance above us, and I'm waiting. I'm holding off. Now, another argument is that the situation we have today is much different than the situation we had in 2014. In 2014, there was not many strong fundamentals. A lot of people weren't even sure that Bitcoin had a future. Now, today, we know that Bitcoin probably has a strong future. But despite this, I'm holding off. Now, I no longer have, you can see if you go back to our videos from a long time ago, 2 months ago, I told you guys, I set a buy order for 2,500. Now, at the time, I got plenty of comments. Some people said, oh, you're going to buy at 2,500. I'm going to buy at 1,800. Now, it's possible Bitcoin never sees 2,500 or 1,800, and then again, it's possible that it does. I think that we're not going to be above $5,000 forever. I think we're definitely going to have to test 4,300, or maybe we'll stay above the 50 or 100 day moving average or the 200 day moving average. We seem to have a cluster of support happening right here. We'll see. Now, I just saw this great tweet by Murad Mahmudov today. Okay. My list of 20 reasons why I think that if 5,400 to the 5,500 area holds, it's very bullish. And if, I repeat, if this area holds, then I'm quite bullish. So he gave a possible scenario where Bitcoin doesn't fall below 5,400 and we continue upwards. It was an interesting read. Anyway, those are my thoughts, guys. To sum up, I'm not buying Bitcoin up here. I'm holding off. I was buying and cost averaging Bitcoin down here. When I bought Bitcoin down here, everybody said I was foolish. Now that I'm not buying Bitcoin up here, probably still a lot of people will think I'm foolish. And that's definitely a probable scenario. I could be very foolish. Now, in the long game, if you buy Bitcoin at 3,000 versus buying Bitcoin at 5,000, obviously, you know, we expect much greater returns in the future. I mean, there's so much reason to think that Bitcoin's future is extremely bright, and there's so many strong fundamentals that are much, much better than 2014 and 2015. But still, if I was buying Bitcoin down here, I'm holding off right here. I'm hoping we come back down, I'll have a chance to buy a little bit lower. But even if we continue going up, I think there would be a strong chance that I would be able to buy just above $6,000. Of course, you know what? Maybe you're right. Maybe Bitcoin will just steadily go up to 100,000. Okay, I'm wrong. Let's get to the news. So Fidelity hires, this is more Fidelity news. This is, I wanted to share this with you because Fidelity continues to build out their digital assets team and they're hiring good people. So Fidelity hires Barclays, former head of digital assets. So financial service giant Fidelity Investments has hired a former head of digital assets project at investment bank Barclays. The new hire, Chris Tyrer, joined Fidelity at the end of April, which is according to his LinkedIn profile update. And the profile, however, does not mention any further details on the role except the mention of digital assets. But Tyrer worked as the head and managing director of digital assets project at Barclays for about 8 months and left the firm in August of 2018. And prior to that, he was the head of commodity trading at the bank between 2015 and 2017. And even before that, he has plenty of experience in the financial system. You can read that here if you want. But in this most recent role, in his most recent role at Barclays, Tyler reportedly worked on exploring the cryptocurrency space. And Barclays had planned to launch a cryptocurrency trading desk last year, but later the bank's CEO pushed back that, saying that there is no immediate plans to open the desk. It's possible they still may. So just last month, Fidelity also hired Coinbase's Director of Institutional Sales, Christine Sandler. And Fidelity, as you know, has over $7 trillion in assets under management and launched its cryptocurrency trading custody platform last month. It was a soft launch for select investors, but Fidelity continues to expand, like many things we're seeing in this bear market. Bitcoin's Lightning Network continues to grow. This is actually a two-parter. Lightning network capacity has increased to facilitate over 8,000 public Lightning nodes, which collectively are worth about $5.6 million. Additionally, the number of active nodes at press time was over 4,000 compared to the same time last month, which it increased by 3%. Each node was seen to have a processing transaction worth on average $1,300, which is approximately 0.25 Bitcoin. So the takeaway here is that not only do people continue to put their trust in Lightning Network and use it and rely on it, the second part of this story is the Lightning Network continues to get, much like Bitcoin, Lightning Network continues to get more user-friendly, easier to use. So for instance, this Lightning Network developer, Alex Bosworth, recently clued us into this information. So normally, sending on Lightning Network requires receivers to create invoices. So if you are going to receive the payment, you have to send the sender an invoice. Well, Alex made a script for IND to gift funds to appear with no invoice. So many of you probably were familiar with Sphinx, which was another development where you wouldn't need to send an invoice. Well, this is actually an improvement on Sphinx. So if I understand it correctly, this will be superior to Sphinx Send because you can actually prove that you made a payment to a given node, paid it in a certain amount, and that payment was successful. I believe Sphinx Send omits the proof of payment part. Sphinx involves sending someone a payment without getting an invoice first. This new method, which I'll call pay them in fees method, until there's a better name for it, does not involve getting an invoice because you create one, and thus you also end up with proof of payment corresponding to that invoice. So that's an improvement over Sphinx Send. Again, the takeaway here is that in the future, I think you can see that not only is Bitcoin going to be seen as a store of value, its transition from store of value, here, let's go to this chart right here. In the future, Bitcoin's transition from store of value to medium of exchange might go pretty fast. See, normally with assets like gold or anything that's ever been used by money, it takes a long time just because you don't really have something like we have today, which is the internet. So it's possible that as soon as Bitcoin becomes a reliable store of value, this adoption is only going to increase exponentially faster. And because Lightning Network is being developed now and technology increases at an exponential rate, I mean, you can see the future is bright. I want to get to a little Craig Wright and Roger Ver news in just a second. But by the way, guys, if you're finding value in today's video, it's kind of a more relaxed video for a Sunday. Do me a favor, hit the like button. Liking our videos, it's a small thing you can do. It truly does help us grow as a channel. And if you're new here to Altcoin Daily, feel free to subscribe. 80,000 people can't be wrong. This channel, it's growing pretty fast. And of course, I have you to thank for that. But I think it's because you find value in our daily videos, either value or education or entertainment. But what I'm proud of us for is that we have 80,000 subscribers right now. It took for many of these crypto YouTubers who started, they started when Bitcoin was rallying from 1,000 to 20,000 and the interest and FOMO in crypto was like no other. A lot of people gained, a lot of other influencers gained all their subscribers in a very short time. And you can see by their viewership that a lot of that viewership has dropped off. We've managed to gain 80,000 subscribers after Bitcoin was already getting into its bear market. We started in February, so right around here. You know, we've been able to grow this channel based on value and education and entertainment in a bear market. So can't wait till the bull market starts and we're going to see some huge numbers. Let's get to some Craig Wright news. So you probably heard this. This news is from a couple days ago. The report is that Craig Wright serves Roger Ver, his former partner, with a libel suit. According to the report, Ver called Wright a fraud and a liar in a YouTube video. So since Roger Ver called Craig Wright a fraud and a liar, Wright sued him. This is Roger Ver's special response to Craig Wright in the libel suit.
Craig Wright is a liar and a fraud, so sue me again.
Very bold. Of course, that doesn't mean I'm going to invest in Bitcoin Cash or Bitcoin SV. I just wanted to share that with you. And our final piece of news, a little Litecoin news, is the Litecoin partners with military-grade wallet. So the Litecoin Foundation announced a collaboration with KoboVault, the military-grade hardware wallet, co-branded by Litecoin. The Kobo tablet is designed for seamless assembly and provides convenient storage of recovery phrases on Kobo tablet for its users. And this partnership was announced via the Litecoin Foundation tweet and looks pretty sleek. So if you're a Litecoin supporter, maybe check this out. Let us know how it all goes. So Bitcoin continues to hold at around 5,700. I mean, we could see Bitcoin stay up here for weeks, right? We'll see. All right, appreciate you guys. See you tomorrow. It's going to be a great year.